to God, and he died on the cross for us. Third is united and aimed, endeavoring to keep the unity of the spirit and the bond of peace. We must have the attitude that we are supposed to be united.
Yeah.
We must see the value of unity and understand that God desires it. Since I've been going to church, and when I was at the Council of Churches, I have observed some people in church who simply do not care about the welfare or the unity of the church.
Wow.
I know it's not here, but they would divide the church over their feelings,
yeah,
their opinions, their preference, false doctrine, their favorites, like those in Corinth. They place human wisdom above God's wisdom. And fourth, united in agreement. In every local church, there are different personality types, different levels of growth. I mean, there's a ENFJ, and all y'all know Myers-Briggs, y'all know it's a ISTJ, and there are all kinds of different personality types. We got different backgrounds. We have different experiences, but that's the richness of the church.
Yeah.
There's one body, one spirit. Just as you were called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God, one Father,
yeah,
of all, who is above all and through all. And if we know it, it is in us. It says in you all. So especially as leaders, we must walk worthy by demonstrating these characteristics.
Mm-hmm.
The only way this happens, and I jumped over from 6 to verse 11, because I couldn't get it all in, Minister Smith. You know how that is, Minister Owen. Is you have to be spiritually mature.
Well,
it says now these are the gifts Christ gave to the church, the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, and the pastor, the teacher. Their responsibility is to equip God's people to do his work and build up the church, the body of Christ. They will continue until we all come to such unity in our faith and knowledge of God's Son that we will be more mature. In the Lord, measuring up to the full and complete standard of Christ, then we will no longer be immature like children. We won't be tossed and blown about like every wind of new teaching. We will not be influenced when people try to trick us with lies so clever that it sounds like the truth. Instead, we speak the truth in love, growing in every way more and more like Christ, who is the head of the body, the church. He makes the whole body. You see, a young person could be more spiritually mature than an older person. Maturity has nothing to do with age. Spiritual maturity. It's demonstrated by the way we walk, not by the way we talk. But walk. The Lord gives leadership gifts to each. And each of these leadership gifts, if you look at them, are centered on people understanding the word of God, showing that the word is foundational to a mature church. If you have church members that don't know the word, you're anemic. The goal is that the entire body will be healthy, that you will grow to unity and maturity in Christ like that. So the leaders, if we are mature, we will grow, or we will be built up. And when I hear this phrase, built up, I think of construction, but that's not what Paul's saying. Paul uses it to talk about the physical and spiritual growth. This includes both adding new members to the body and seeing the present members grow in the word of God. Somebody needs to say hallelujah. And the first sense we read in the early chapters of Acts how the Lord was adding to their numbers day by day. And so we should be praying that the Lord start adding to our numbers. And in the second sense of the word, being built up refers to spiritual growth among those who are saved. As Paul wrote, we proclaim him, admonishing every man and teaching every man with all wisdom, so that we may be present, every man complete in Christ. Complete in Christ. And then he says, therefore, as you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, having been firmly rooted and now build up in him and establishing your faith, just as you were instructed and overflowing with gratitude. See, in these scriptures, Paul is saying that we need the word to be built up.
Yeah.
We need instructions.
Yeah.
Paul tells us if we are leaders, if the leaders are mature, the body will obtain the unity of the faith.
Yeah.
There are phrases in verse 4:13, each beginning with the word to. It says, come to the unity of the faith, of the knowledge of the Son of God. That's one phrase. And then it says, to a mature man. Or a mature woman. That's the second phrase. And then it says, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. You see, we're on a journey. We're not there yet. We won't be there until Christ comes. But every day we're supposed to be growing. So Paul is referring here to doctrinal unity that comes through the teaching of the word. The more we understand God's word, the more unity.
Yeah.
Paul's not just talking about quoting scripture about Christ.
All right.
Rather, he's talking about knowing the Son of God in an intimate way. It's all right to start quoting scripture, but if you don't know him, it's just empty words. As we come to know Christ more deeply, we will experience closer unity in Christ. That's Paul's point. And when we have mature leaders, the church will grow to be mature. When we have mature leaders, the church will grow to be mature. This is in contrast with the picture in verse 4:14 of the church as children tossed about by every wave and wind of doctrine. So Paul is not just referring to our individual maturity. Yes, we have to individually mature, but also to our corporate maturity as a church in our relationship with one another to accomplish the vision. Then Paul says, if we have mature leaders, the body will grow to the fullness of Christ. John MacArthur says it this way. You know John MacArthur, ministers. The church in the world is Jesus Christ in the world.
All right.
Because the church is now the fullness of his incarnate body in the world. We are to radiate and reflect Christ's perfection.
Yeah.
So the goal is that the church would grow to complete Christ's likeness so that the world looks at us and it sees Christ. It doesn't see a church being tossed about. It doesn't see a church